गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम निवेदिता सिंह देव ऑफ मारवाड़ी कॉलेज इंग्लिश डिपार्टमेंट. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक योर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फॉर इंग्लिश कोर दैट इज़ ऑफ 100 मार्क्स. टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द बुक विस्टास. विस्टास एज प्रीवियसली वी हैव स्टार्टेड द ऑल द लेसन्स फ्रॉम 1 to 6. टुडे वी विल हैव लेसन नंबर 7. विस्टास लेसन नंबर 7, इवांस ट्राइज एन जीरो लेवल बाय कॉलिन डेक्स्टर. मेन कैरेक्टर्स इवांस, गवर्नर, सेक्रेटरी ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन बोर्ड, इनविजिलेटर स्टुअर्ड मैक्लेरी, prison officers Jackson and Stephen, German language teacher. The story starts as examination board receives a call from Oxford prison. It was early March. The secretary of the examination board receives a call from Oxford prison. A chap called Evans started night classes in zero level German last September. He is very near to get some sort of academic qualification. The governor inquires about the procedure. The secretary asks him not to worry about it. It will be sending him all the forms and other necessary things. He inquires about Evans. The governor assures him that there is no record of violence against Evans. It is decided to examine him in his prison cell. One of the persons from St. Mary Mag's school is arranged to invigilate. The prison officers call him Evans the Brake. He had already escaped from prison 3 times. At 8:30 in the morning, Evans had 2 visitors. Jackson and was the senior prison officer on D wing where Evans was prisoned. He and Evans had already become warm enemies. Stephens was a burly surly officer. Evans' face is unshaven. He wears a dirty red and white bobble hat upon his head. He make sure that his razor and nail scissors are taken away. He is given 30 minutes to smarten himself or clean up himself. McClary carries a brown suitcase. It contains all necessary papers, including a sealed question paper envelope. The 2-hour examination is to start at 9:15 a.m. Stephens brings 2 small square tables and 2 hard chairs. He placed them opposite to each other. They are taking no chances with Evans. Stuart McClary is greeted by Jackson at D wing in the prison. It will be very difficult for Evans to make another break. He is sitting in a locked cell and all the prison officers are on alert. The invigilator's duty is to ensure that the strictest Silence is observed. The governor is worried about McCleary. If he had brought something, even a jackknife, Evans can hold him hostage with such a weapon. The examinee and the invigilator have already been introduced by Stephens. McCleary asks Evans to write the name of the paper, his index number, etc. At 9:40 a.m., the assistant secretary speaks to the governor. They had forgotten to place a correction slip in the examination package. Jackson fears if the phone call is fake or it is some signal. But everything seems to be all right. Evans sits staring straight in front of him, holding his pen between his lips. And opposite to him sits McCleary. At 10:50 a.m., Evans wants a blanket around his shoulders. He is feeling cold. At 10:51 a.m., Stephen was surprised to see a gray blanket wrapped around Evans' shoulder. Stephen wonders if Evans is not planning a sudden Batman leap to suffocate McCleary in the blanket. At 11:20 a.m., McCleary informs Evans that only 5 minutes remain. At 11:22 a.m., Governor wants to speak to Stephens. He wants him to accompany McCleary to the main gates. At 11:25, McCleary announces, "Stop writing, please." Stephen walks with McCleary to the main gate. Two abnormalities can be noticed here by Stephens. McCleary's Scott accent seems broader than ever. His long black overcoat is reaching almost his knees. These two things he had not seen while McCleary had entered the prison cell. Today, up to now, we will continue with the chapter in next video.